Hey, my name is Jens and today I got some pretty incredible photography ideas you have to try at home. Maybe you've already guessed it, but today we're gonna play with fire. Okay, let's go. I had to switch the location because I'm on vacation right now. I'm on Langeoog. To create this fire effect, I mean this fireball, I mixed water with this washing liquid and I guess it's called lighter fuel. By adding the lighter fuel, you can create those bubbles which at the end create that fire effect to your object. Yeah, that was my first try and it didn't really work because the plate where I put the fluid inside was too small. And it really depends on the amount of lighter fuel you put inside the fluid. As you can see in this example, nothing really happens. So it's not too dangerous, but get sure to just use a little bit of lighter fuel and create small bubbles, or you should go outside. Here you can see a mistake I did, because I did not wait after adding the lighter fuel. After a couple of seconds, lighter fuel which is not inside the bubbles will disappear. If you do not wait, you can light up the environment, and that's something I really would not recommend. Okay, that's the basic setup. Now I went outside and was looking for some kind of flowers, and I also found a feather. And then I used some putty or play-doh to mount the flower inside our plate in the middle and surround it with a bubble. Okay, let's start with this flower, which is still closed. I have added some coins because I wanted to add some weight so that it does not move around. And which was really surprising here is that the flower started to open up while the fire appeared. But this creates some really nice effect, like time lapse combined with a slow motion fire effect, which I really liked. Okay, one more look on the setup I used. I used two cameras. One camera, which is filming right now, the Sony a7R 4 together with a 24mm, just to give you an overview of my setup. And a second camera, the Sony a6300 with a 90mm macro lens, to get a close-up. So we always have two perspectives of everything which is going on here. Then I have added a ring light and a small video light as well, because I wanted to shoot at fast shutter speed and low ISO. Okay, back to the next image. I have added the fire to the bubbles, and with the other hand I have pushed the trigger of my Sony a6300, which is turned to burst mode. So I took like 10 or 20 images while the fireball appears, and hopefully to get two or three really cool images. And one addition, I have set my camera focus to manual and set the focus before I started lighting up everything. Okay, let's have a first look on the results using this small flower. They are pretty cool. I really like that the fire is not damaging the flower, just offering and giving a nice warm background. Oh, this one is pretty cool because the fire hides the, what is it called? No internet. The thing which is connected to the flower. What is it called? I have no idea. Pretty interesting and pretty good start, I guess. In the next following minutes, I'm going to show you how to improve and how to add some highlights to the image. Let's try another flower and see how this one looks. Pretty the same, pretty interesting. And then I thought, okay, a flower with flames look pretty cool, but I want to improve the image, and that's why I added some water droplets by using a pump spray. resulting in this photo series. What do you think? I must say that I really don't like that the flower looks just wet. Maybe there are some small water droplets which look pretty cool, but somehow this looked not clean for me. So I had to change the setup again. Okay, before I'm gonna show you how to create perfect round water droplets on a flower, I just want to show you some footage I took with a high-speed camera. Lean back and enjoy. If you want to see more slow motion footage like this, please leave a comment below, because I have done that a lot in the past. But I kinda stopped, because the photography ideas video just seemed to work much better for you guys. Okay, let's see how the water droplets on the flower with the fire look. Yeah, that looks just much better. You get those nice fire reflections in the water droplets, and I really like it. Maybe you've noticed that I used large aperture number. That's because I needed a large field of depth, because I wanted to capture as much detail of the water droplets as possible. The next image I'm going to show you is really my favorite one, because the feather is going crazy inside that fire. Let's take a closer look. Same procedure, I have added some lighter fuel to the water with the dishwashing liquid, and then set everything on fire and fired with a burst mode. And surprisingly, the feather was completely burned and ruined, and the smell was really, really bad. But when I reviewed the images, I was really satisfied. Let's have a look. Oh, one addition. Here I used an aperture of 3.2. Because the feather is very, very plain, I could use a very short field of depth and at the same time a little faster shutter speed at low ISO number. Yeah, I must say those images really went out very, very cool. And again here, you can see that blue fire on the bottom. That's the same mistake. I did forget to wait till all the lighter fuel in the air was vanished. And this is really kind of risky. Don't do that. Please wait till you use the fire to light everything up. Yeah, here are some images with a little bit of smoke, which looks also pretty interesting. And yeah, and those are uncropped images, so at 24 megapixel we can go much closer and capture a lot of detail here, especially when you shoot at an ISO of 100 as I did here. And at the end, the fire formed those bubbles out of the feathers, which look pretty, I don't know, strange, nasty, I don't know. Let's take a closer look. From the macro perspective, this somehow looks as if the feather was made of iron. Yeah, I was pretty happy with the results, because I was expecting nothing, and then I could get those images. What do you think? Will you try feather fire photography? And I have just light up one feather, so maybe I'm experimenting a little bit more with different feathers, different sizes, different colors, and maybe we can get even more cool images. We will see. What about this macro? I've taken it on a tripod, so I could use really, really low shutter speeds, because I had not added some light using fire, for example. And yeah, I really like this metal iron look, pretty cool. Okay, totally different topic. I have found this kind of, I don't know if it's a seed or a fruit, but it is very, very dry. I have no idea what it's called. If you know, maybe you could tell me, leave a comment below, because I just thought, hey, it's super, super dry. Probably there will happen something interesting when you mix a very dry thing with fire, or a very stupid thing. We will see. Okay, I have set my lighting setup again, added some bubbles with lighter fuel. Oh, one addition here, I have used my finger to move the bubbles around the object so that the fire is in the fore and the background, resulting in a much more interesting image. Oh, there are really a couple interesting birds around here. I think I'm gonna make a wildlife photography video soon. Oh, that's some ducks flying around and a fazan. Again, I have no idea what's in English. I will look that up. Okay, then I've set everything on fire, and that's the result. And somehow the super, super dry seat did not burn. So yeah, this should actually be the finale of this photography series. So I have added a lot more heat to finally burn it down. And again, please do not try this at home. I have done everything you saw in this video at home, and when you don't use too much lighter fuel, it is really not dangerous, but it could be if you do something wrong. So please go outside and do your first tests outside, and when you know how much fuel is good for a good image, then yeah, you can get comfortable with the fire and maybe go inside. I hope that I could give you a little bit of inspiration and that you like this kind of fire photography. If you have any questions regarding my setup, feel free to leave a comment below. As always, I will answer every comment and of course give you some tips if you need. Yeah, if you like this kind of content, I'd really appreciate a like, or if you have not done it already, maybe you want to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get fresh photography ideas weekly, sometimes even twice a week. So stay healthy and hopefully see you in the next video.